गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव. यस्टरडे वी डिड द पोएम द फॉक्स एंड द ग्रेप्स एंड यू नो वेरी वेल दैट इट्स अ वेरी फेमस स्टोरी ऑल्सो द फॉक्स एंड द ग्रेप्स. द फॉक्स वॉज वेरी हंग्री एंड ही सर्च्ड हियर एंड देयर द फूड बट इन द एंड ही गॉट a bunch of grapes but it was very much high. The fox could not reach by jumping again and again. And at last he remarked that the grapes are sour and he went away from there. So this is the story, the fox and the grapes, and the same is the poem. So today we are going to discuss the exercise of the same. See, the lines are there. Read the poem carefully and fill in the blanks. Means we have to read the poem and we have to fill the blanks on the basis of the reading. Right? See the number one. Number one. The fox was feeling faint because he was very hungry. Because he was very hungry. The fox was very hungry. Therefore, he was going to faint. Now the second one is, while passing through an dash, he suddenly spotted a dash of grapes. So while passing through an orchard, he suddenly spotted a bunch of grapes. Then the third one, he tried to get at it by jumping but missed it. The fourth one, he wiped his tearful eyes because he could not get grapes. Because he was trying hard again and again but he was not able to get the grapes. Therefore he wiped his tearful eyes. The five number, finally he decided to go away. He decided to go away from there because he was not able to get the grapes. So he decided to go away. Then the last one is, he comforted himself with the thought that, what thought came into his mind? Yes, the thought was that the grapes were sour. Angoor khatte hain. So this was the thought that came into his mind and he went away from there. Now see the second one. Choose the answer that is very much closest in meaning to the phrase given below. The number one, you see. What does the fox mean when he says that the result were much the same? The fox was able to reach the bunch of grapes. The fox ate all the grapes himself. The fox could not reach the grapes. This is the right answer. I have made a tick for you so that you can do. Then the second one, the purple cluster means. The purple cluster, we know very well that it was the purple colored grapes. A bunch of grapes was there that was of purple color. The third one, the leaps were desperate and high because the fox was. Why was the fox jumping high and high? What was the reason for that? Because the fox was extremely hungry and the grapes were very tempting. The fox was extremely hungry and the grapes are very tempting. The fourth one, by saying the grapes were sour, the fox meant. By saying the fox, what is the meaning of the fox? That the grapes were beyond his reach and he did not want to admit defeat. The grapes were beyond his reach and he did not want to admit defeat. So these are the MCQs. Now see the next. A3. Here are some adjectives that appear in this poem. Tick the ones you think describe the fox. Then write the reason why you think so. So let us discuss. So the first one is very much hungry. The fox was hungry, we know, because he was in the search of the food. Then the second one is desperate. It was very much desperate, that's why it was jumping again and again. Hungry, desperate. Then the third one is persistent, means doing the work continuously he was jumping, but not able to get the bunch of grapes. Then it is hardworking, that the fox is very much hardworking because it is doing a lot of labor to get the grapes. Then the last one is adjusting also. He made an adjustment when he was not able to get the bunch of grapes. So he made the remark that the grapes were sour. So in this way he was adjusting also. Now see the appreciation. Look at the words at the end of each line in the poem. Do they rhyme? Make a list of the words that rhyme in the poem. Yes, the words are rhyming. And the words are, you can see the poem also. See here. See the last word. True, true, fall, wall, it, aim, same. High, I, dry, are, sour. So these are the rhyming words, and the rhyme scheme is also AABB. The rhyme scheme is also AABB. Now see the next. This question. You have to fill in the blank with the rhyming word. So I have written for you people, and they are very easy, you can do them. Pin, sin, chin, ten man plan, plant and chant, bang, hang, sang, butt, shut, cut. Okay. And now see the downside. See, it's a rhyme that you have done in class nursery. See, ding dong bell, pussy in the well, who put her in? Little Jonathan. Who pulled her out? Little Tommy Stout. What a naughty boy was that, to try to drown poor pussy cat. So you can sing it in a rhythmic way, and you can write the words. The words are given upside. Ding dong bell, pussy in the well, who put her in? Little Jonathan. Who pulled her out? Little Tommy Stout. What a naughty boy was that, to try it round the pussy cat. So it's your exercise that we have done today, and on the next page also the fill in the blanks are there and the poem is there, so you also fill that, and then the words are there, they are for pronunciation, so you will do all these words. Okay. And on the last page of the book, on page number 30, you see that a blank is there and you have to write a story. The story, the fox and the grapes, you have done many times. You have heard, and you have heard the poem also. You have read the poem also. So you can do. So you have to write the poem in the form of the story. And the name of the story is The Fox and the Grapes. I think you can do it. And you just write it and show me. So it's bye for today. It's your homework also. Bye, students. Have a nice day.